Hey you guys, so I have quite a lot to update you guys on. I did record some stuff before going to sleep last night, but because I've never used my laptop to take videos, I saved it to the wrong thing, and really all I was doing was updating on some stuff that happened. It wasn't anything groundbreaking, so I decided to just kind of skip yesterday, and today I'm gonna catch you up on like everything that happened. And then 2 days ago I do have videos to upload to a vlog for, so today's the 7th, so for the 5th. But my phone broke, so my phone is completely out of commission. My screen does not work. I can't hit like physically see anything on the screen. And my camera's broken, so my only option is to do this with the webcam, which I'm sorry, the quality is not the greatest, but I want to continue vlogging and it gives me something to do and I enjoy doing it, and so I'm going to just continue to do it because why not? It gives me something to do. So 2 days ago I came in with a fever. And when I upload the video from the 5th, then you'll see kind of the progression of how the day went. So I was brought to the emergency room, and we were worried I was septic. My fever was like 101.4, and it shot up from like 99 to that in a matter of like 2 hours. And I was in a lot of pain, and just having like shortness of breath and stuff like that. So we were really worried I was septic, and they gave me antibiotics in the emergency room, and I thought actually I was getting discharged, but then they admitted me, and I didn't really get up to my room until I think like 7 o'clock last night. So I hadn't slept in like 26 hours straight, because this is now technically it's my third day here, but not really, it's like my second, right? Yeah, because I've only been here for just under 48 hours or something. Anyway, so I still have my line. I'm not septic. I just found out that some of my blood cultures came back and there was a bacteria in the blood culture, but they said it's not something that's commonly found in the blood and that it's probably something that got contaminated when they were taking my blood. So they're gonna, I've got vancomycin, which is like a broad spectrum antibiotic, and I got that in the emergency room, and then they felt like I didn't need it. So instead, you know, we waited, and I just spoke to the doctor now, and they're gonna just like treat it as mild sepsis, even though it's not sepsis. The other concerning things were that my platelets are very, very low. Platelets are supposed to be from, I believe, 150 to 300, and my platelets normally are about 115-ish, and when they checked my blood work yesterday or 2 days ago, they found that my platelets were like 82 or something like that, when they're supposed to be 150. And it explains, like, I have a lot of, like, really random bruising on different parts of my body. I have them on my legs, my arms. I don't even know if you can really see, but I'm like bleeding. I don't know if you can even see that. I'm like bleeding underneath my skin. You can't see that, but this came out of nowhere yesterday. I have it on my stomach and my back and stuff like that. But my platelets, again, usually run about 115. So I am going to see hematologist. Most likely I won't be getting a blood transfusion, but the doctor was really surprised that I never had it suggested to see a hematologist before, so they're going to send somebody up to talk to me about my platelets to figure out what's going on. And then we requested an iron infusion, but my numbers aren't low enough to get the iron infusion, so that's not happening. But I'm anemic. I've been anemic for a few weeks now, or at least to what we know. They have me on like a clear liquids diet. So I'm getting pretty much like Jell-O, apple juice, like ice, Pisces or whatever those things are called. These guys used to get them. I got these at school all the time when I was little. And they are giving me high protein nutrition. So they're also going to have gastroenterology come up so we can talk about what to do about my GI problems. I think that's pretty much it. Adrian was here last night. 2 days ago, my mom dropped me off. She was here for about 2 hours and left, and she did the same last week, actually. She just dropped me off at the emergency room and left, and I was alone the entire time. And I won't badmouth my family or Adrian's family pretty much ever, because it's disrespectful and rude and everything, but I am mad at my mom. I told her not to come to see me because I was in the emergency room sobbing for like a solid 2 to 3 hours because I wasn't getting pain medication and I was in so much pain. And then yesterday, when I got up to my room, as soon as we got up, I was throwing up. So we really don't know what's going on. And then the last thing really is that they're going to have a IV nurse come, and we're going to talk about having my PIC replaced. And the IV nurse last night said that I think they'd be able to put the guide wire through my PIC that I have now, pull my PIC out, and then just slide a new PIC in. I would just have to do that at interventional radiology. So I'm going to try to really push to have it replaced. I had to have it cleared early this morning, and that's a fourth time in 6 months. And I'm running fluids. I'm not running TPN, which is really thick. You know, I'm running something that should be, you know, it's like close to no risk of clogging. So I'm gonna like hope that they're gonna replace the line, and hopefully they can keep it in the same space. I just really hope that the IV nurse is on the same page with me, because it's unbelievable that this is the fourth time I've had to have it cleared and all I'm running is fluid. So I'm gonna keep you guys updated. I just wanted to update you basically with everything that's going on. I apologize for not having the video from yesterday, but yeah, I'm back. And yeah, I'll keep you guys updated. It's about noon right now, 11:30. I think something I'm going to do today too is do a separate video, like not a vlog, of my like hospital room tour and what I pack when I go to the hospital. So I think that would be a lot of fun. So I think I'm gonna do that tonight. I'm just catching up on YouTube stuff, and my parents are gonna come pretty soon for a little bit. And I'm just waiting to be spoken to from gastroenterology and hematology and IV nurse about replacing my PIC. So just want to let you guys know I'm excited. So my mom is here right now. I'm running, I think my thing. Just a few things to update with you. And then we have to figure out further testing with gastroenterology and hematology. So this is easily going to be more than a week. But, you know, I'm finally in the hospital trying to get down to the bottom of what's going on with my stomach and to start hopefully gaining weight back. So yeah, I'm just watching the Golden Globes. Still running the Vanco for... So yeah, that's basically what's going on. My mom got what Adrian got yesterday. He got this wrap and it was so good. I had like 2 bites. And my mom got it, so I got to take a few bites of that. It was really good. I miss food. So, yeah, I'm just hanging out, watching the Golden Globes. I'll try to edit this tonight, hopefully. And I'm going to... I want to give like a hospital room tour tomorrow, and like what I packed for the hospital, because I think that would be Hey guys, so it is 8:30. I am live streaming the live coverage of the Golden Globes, which is something to do. I'm happy I could get it to work. I only met with a dietitian today. Gastroenterology hasn't seen me. Hematology hasn't seen me, and the IV nurse hasn't seen me. So didn't really accomplish much, but I at least have like this ongoing relationship now with the dietitian. She said that we're going to start with, because earlier, I don't even think I said this, my family came and we were hanging out, but like 20 minutes before that, I had Jell-O and apple juice, and I threw up the Jell-O and apple juice, so I'm having a really hard time tolerating food. So the kitchen's now sending up broth for me. I got a whole bunch, so I'm on my third one. They sent me four, I'm on my third one. And the dietitian, we're gonna try to kind of slowly change what my body's able to tolerate, and then and I trust this opinion, but she's saying unless something crazy happens, no TPN, which is perfectly fine. They're saying possibly a temporary feeding tube, depending on how everything starts going. This is easily turning into at least a week in the hospital, which is interesting because the guy that I saw yesterday was like, yeah, we're gonna get you out tomorrow. I haven't even met with the gastroenterology team, so I'm having both fluids and vancomycin. When infectious disease came earlier, they said that there was something in my bacteria. He said it's not a bacteria that would be in my blood. He thinks that there was like a contamination when they were acting the blood, but they're still gonna ask if it was like infection, but they're not taking the line out. Hey guys, so I'm going to just close out the vlog because I feel myself getting tired, and it's about 9:30, so I'm probably taking like the nighttime meds. In a half an hour, I think they do it at 10, but I'm just really tired in general, so, yeah, I wanted to close out the vlog. Fingers crossed, Adrian will be here tomorrow after work for a little bit. I don't know how long, though, because if I don't see him tomorrow night, I'm not going to be seeing him until Wednesday night, so we'll see. I miss him. And then if he does come, he's going to be bringing... he doesn't know this yet, but I'm gonna have him bring the shower wipes that I mentioned a couple of vlogs ago, and I know they have these like shower caps that you like put on and it washes your hair and you don't have to get your hair wet, so I'm gonna ask for that too. My mom brought lotion and body spray for me, so I can just feel like I smell clean and feel a little bit clean. Gonna through that stuff, and then hopefully gastroenterology and hematology are kind to me. This is just gonna turn into a long hospitalization, and I'm looking forward to it. And the post-hospital hangover is gonna be terrible. Anyway.